The U.S. Air Force official overseeing the B-21 Raider stealth bomber program has provided an update on the progress. Randy Walden said the bomber, which is being developed and manufactured by Northrop Grumman, is beginning to look like an airplane. Viewers may note that on January 31, 2020, the U.S. Air Force, along with Northrop Grumman, released three new renderings of the B-21. All three of these featured the same artist concept of the aircraft photoshopped into real pictures of hangars at Ellsworth Air Force Base in South Dakota, Whiteman Air Force Base in Missouri, and Dyess Air Force Base in Texas. According to the USAF, the B-21 stealth bomber is scheduled to be rolled out for public view in 2021 and could fly as early as December 2021. The bomber is being assembled at a secure government-owned contractor-operated facility known as Air Force Plant 42 near Palmdale, California, which is 3 million square feet of industrial space and is near Edwards Air Force Base. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the world's most sophisticated bomber, B-21 Raider, is shaping up. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. Randy Walden stated, "Suppliers from across the country are delivering parts that are coming together now. Aircraft programs will always have a few surprises early on, and we won't be any different. But overall, the B-21 Raider is coming along nicely." Speaking at a Mitchell Institute for Aerospace Studies event, Mr. Walden stated that some suppliers who were affected in their commercial venture due to the pandemic are boosting the production of the B-21 bomber. For example, Spirit AeroSystems, which builds the large composite aerostructures for the B-21 bomber, also manufactures structural components for the 737 MAX. He said, "The folks that are not manufacturing 737s and those components came over to our production line and really kind of beefed up. Where people had some COVID issues, they beefed up that portion of our production. Right now, the components that we're building are really for the test fleet, but the good news, all of what we're doing today is really insightful for what we're doing for production in the future." Air Force General Timothy Ray, head of Air Force Global Strike Command, AFGSC, said, "The progress I saw today further adds to my confidence that the B-21 Raider will preserve our long-range strike and penetrating bomber capability. We're excited to get the B-21 Raider to bases in the mid-2020s. B-21 is being developed under the Long Range Strike Bomber, LRSB, program. A request for proposal to develop the aircraft was issued in July 2014. On the 25th of October 2013, Boeing and Lockheed Martin announced they're teaming up for the LRSB. The other participant was Northrop Grumman. On the 27th of October 2015, the U.S. Department of Defense awarded the development contract to Northrop Grumman. The deciding factor in the selection of the Northrop design was cost. The B-21 Raider is envisaged to be a super stealthy bomber, which will be able to penetrate the most sophisticated air defenses for decades into the future, and be able to take out high-value enemy targets without the rival even knowing it was there in the first place. The bomber will have a very long range and high payload capacity to carry conventional and nuclear weapons. B-21 is expected to replace the U.S. Air Force's aging fleets of B-1, B-2, and B-52 strategic bombers, which have an average age of 27 years. The production contract could be worth $55 billion for 100 airplanes, with an initial deal of $23.5 billion for the first five aircraft with R&D. Anti-access, area denial A2 AD system refuse U.S. forces the ability to come within hundreds or even thousands of miles of an enemy's territory. Today, these high-end capabilities are being developed and deployed by countries like China and Russia, but they'll soon be available to others as well. These capabilities include advanced integrated air defense systems with long-range engagement capabilities, able to target and shoot down aircraft from hundreds of miles away, as well as increasingly capable ballistic missiles that can put America's fixed installations and even U.S. carrier strike groups at risk throughout an entire region. A country with a strong A2 AD capability has basically created an invisible fortress wall that can be pushed out thousands of miles from its territorial borders. The most potent example of this is the S-400 Triumph, which can detect targets at a range of 600 kilometers or 373 miles and engage them at a range of 400 kilometers or 250 miles. S-400 is a dangerous threat to everything except the most advanced stealth fighters and bombers. This renders all the fourth generation fighters like F-16s and F-18s obsolete. Russia is also developing S-500, which will be even more advanced. This is where B-21 Raider will come into the picture. B-21 will be very much an enabler for other air combat systems. It will fly deep into enemy airspace to take out the rival's AD-A2 capability and render them partially defenseless. Apart from tactical and strategic bombing missions, the Raider is expected to be able to conduct surveillance, reconnaissance, intelligence, and electronic attack. The new B-21 Raider looks very similar to its B-2 Spirit. Actually, it will look startlingly similar to the original Advanced Strategic Penetration Aircraft, ASPA, and the later Advanced Technology Bomber concept from the 1980s that ultimately resulted in the B-2. B-21 Raider will go one step ahead of B-2 Spirit when it comes to stealth. Initially, B-2 Spirit was designed for high-altitude penetration missions, but the Spirit was redesigned late in the game to operate at low altitudes. The redesign caused a decrease in range and payload, as well as a larger radar cross-section. B-21 will have no such limitations, and its stealth characteristic is intended to not only elude higher frequency engagement radars that allow air defenses to actually target an aircraft, but also counter lower frequency surveillance radar, which, though can't be used for tracking, can be used for detection. Invisibility to lower frequency surveillance radar is important too. Since though these cannot be used to guide the missiles, they can be used by the enemy to direct warplanes to the vicinity of B-21 for a possible interception. Significant improvement is expected in the external structure, radar-absorbing material that's used, as well as methods to reduce the heat signature from the engine. Apart from the stealth, the avionics, sensor suite, and weapons package all will see considerable enhancements. B-21 Raider is being designed so that it can accommodate the latest technologies. When B-2 Spirit was deployed, it was steps ahead of opposing tech, and the same is expected from B-21 Raider. The interesting thing to note that Russia and China has not yet developed a truly stealth fighter, let alone a bomber which is generally larger and harder to make low observable. In this situation, it will be difficult for them to counter something they haven't grasped properly until now. B-21 Raider's ability to carry both conventional as well as nuclear bombs will lend a lot of flexibility to the kind of missions it can undertake and provide the U.S. Air Force with a tactical edge when it comes to battle scenarios.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.